Katherine from Double O Kidney here. Welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Today, getting tested for kidney problems has become incredibly difficult and, in some cases, even dangerous. Well, this could be finally over! In today's video, I'll show you how to get tested for kidney function, creatinine levels, and proteinuria at home for just $5. Incredible! You just need one of these. This is a urinalysis strip. It's the same device labs use to do urinalysis. And getting tested at home may be incredibly useful if you have symptoms of kidney disease. It can save your life! So if you have bubbles in the urine, changes in the urination patterns, or tiredness, but you don't know what is causing the symptoms, use one of these immediately. Instead of wondering if something is wrong with your kidneys, you can do a test and know the answer in a matter of minutes. But also, if you have already been diagnosed with kidney disease, this strip can tell your creatinine levels and other very important values, such as glucose levels, pH, and more. Really useful because you can save a trip to the doctor and get tested at home easily. Remember that getting tested is a very important part of the treatment. No cure is going to work if your doctor doesn't know what to treat. Now, these strips are widely available on Amazon or eBay. Even some pharmacies carry them. But it's very important that you watch this video till the end before buying any of these urinalysis kits. There is a key factor you absolutely need to know. So, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to use these strips to test for proteinuria, the very first symptom of kidney disease, and also to test for creatinine levels. Now you may ask, so what's the catch? Can I really do a complete test for kidney function at home for just $5? Well, as you can see from my title, this is a no clickbait video, alright? And this may be a rare occurrence here on YouTube, but yes! You can absolutely do a complete urine test at home for $5. Actually, I paid 4.38 euros, which is around $5 for this box you can see here. Yes, I paid. This is not an affiliate review and I'm not getting paid by anyone to promote anything. I will still provide you a link in the description if you want to buy these strips on Amazon, but it's gonna be an Amazon Smile link. Amazon will donate to your favorite charitable organization at no cost to you if you use this link. But again, please watch the whole video before buying anything. And by the way, this is a complete kidney function test. Now, this box contains 4 usable strips, so you pay what? $1 per test? And obviously, if you purchase a bigger box, the cost per test is going to be much lower and the results are going to be valid too. These are the same strips labs use, you know? All the brands I've bought receive enough certifications to be used both at home and by labs. So yes, you can get tested at home for kidney function in literally just 5 minutes and for less than $5. Now, do you want to see how these work? So, let's say you want to be tested for proteinuria. This is a very important test, the first thing to do if you don't know if you have kidney disease. Proteinuria or albuminuria means that your kidneys are leaking albumin or other proteins in the urines. Healthy kidneys shouldn't do that. Now, I have 2 different types of tests I want to show you. 2 different products from 2 different brands, and both of these can tell you if you have proteinuria. This one in particular is called Reactive and it's made by DFI Co, a company based in Korea and distributed by an English company. A truly international product you should be able to find anywhere. But let's see how it works. First of all, there are 2 ways to use the strips. You can prepare a urine sample in a container. To test for proteinuria, the container doesn't have to be sterile. As the manual tells us, you just need to use a clean and dry container. Also, you need to make sure there are no traces of any detergents in the container. So you can use any container as long as it's clean. But as the manual says here, you don't even need a container at all to use this test. Now, this test can be performed at any time of the day, but it's advisable not to drink a lot of water before testing. What you absolutely need are two things. First, a stopwatch or a stopwatch app like you have on your phone. Then, a camera. You probably can use your phone for both these things. I'm telling you this because the test areas are going to work for a very limited amount of time. Manufacturers specifically ask to only read the test areas after 60 seconds. So, in my opinion, you want to take a picture of the strip after exactly 60 seconds. Be sure to include both the test strip and the color chart in the picture and to take it in a well-lit area. So we prepare a urine sample. Then we dip the test strip in the urine sample. And we time exactly 60 seconds. Then we take a picture of the test strip against the color chart we have found in the box. Easy! Now we only need to read the results. It's really easy to read actually. Now, if someone without kidney problems does one of these tests, the first color here should be yellow. If the first test area becomes green, that means there is protein in the urine. Now, if the test area is just slightly green, it means that there are protein traces. This may happen even in people without kidney problems. But if you have reasons to believe you have kidney problems, this may already be a symptom. So, if you also have other symptoms of kidney disease such as changes in the urination patterns, fatigue, difficulty focusing, itchy skin or swollen ankles, watch out for this result. Any result besides yellow or slightly green here is not normal. It means you actually have protein in your urine. If this happens, repeat the test after a day to rule out a false positive. If it's still positive, consult your doctor. Now, as you can see, there are various other test areas here. Some of these are very important. Specific gravity should be taken into account too. You see, this one, SG, that's specific gravity. This test area should be at least in the green or orange area for the test to be valid. If this value is below 1010 or here, it means your urine are too diluted and you would have to repeat the test after 2 or 3 hours without drinking too much water. And if we take a look at this strip, there are other tests that can help a correct diagnosis. For example, glucose here is usually a sign of diabetes. This test area should be as blue as possible. The more green or even brown it becomes, the more the glucose or sugar in the urine. Blood too should be checked. It can be a sign of an infection or kidney problems. Finding blood in the urine requires further testing. So with this one, we can easily test for proteinuria. Guys, let me know if everything was clear. Feel free to ask in comment section for any clarification. Now, the other very important thing you can use these strips for is to test for creatinine levels. To do this, you will need a test specifically made for kidney problems, like this one here. This other test I have here is made in Germany by a company called Nahl von Minden GmbH. This strip is made to test specifically for kidney problems, as you can see. It has one disadvantage. It's a lot harder to find than the other one I have shown you earlier. Only one brand was available here in Italy. I had to buy this from eBay and wait about a month to get it. Still, it may be worth the wait. A single strip provides just three tests. First, protein in urine, like the one before, specific gravity and creatinine levels. So, if you need to test for kidney function, find a test strip with creatinine levels. Not many products have this important test. It works the same way as the other one. You dip the strip in a urine sample and check the color against the color chart you find in the box. Now, if we take a look at the color chart here, we may see that these are not the creatinine levels you may be used to. The creatinine levels lab test will give you are taken from a blood and a urine test. Now, creatinine is supposed to be higher in your urine and lower in your blood. So, the higher creatinine is in urine, the better. This level can roughly tell how much your kidneys are working. If this test area becomes green or slightly greenish, it means your kidneys are excreting enough creatinine. If it's yellow, it means there's not enough creatinine in the urine. So guys, I've tried to simplify this part as much as possible. So if you have any doubt about how these strips work, feel free to ask in comment. I'll show you in a moment how to buy them. First, there's a very important thing to know about this kind of urinalysis. What to know? As I was saying in the beginning of the video, there is something you absolutely need to know before buying these urinalysis test strips. Actually, there are two things you need to know before buying. First, these tests have two expiration dates. The one written outside here is 1 year and a half, but it's only true for unopened packages, right? This is very important. As soon as you open the package, the strips are going to be stable for just 30 days. This is very important because not all manufacturers will individually package the strips. Now, most of these tests are sold in boxes of 100 strips, alright? But they cost almost the same as a 10 strips box. These tests are mostly sold to labs and they prefer to buy larger amounts, obviously. So maybe you'll buy a 100 strips box to save money and then you'll have to discard 95 test strips because they're all useless after 30 days. Or worse, unreliable. Don't do that. And don't use strips after 30 days of opening the box. Either find individually packaged strips like this sold by Reactive or by smaller amounts. The other very important thing, do these tests really work? Well, let's just say that when I started working on this video, I wanted to do a review. I wanted to test these strips on myself and maybe on some other people too and see if the results were compatible with urinalysis done at the lab. But I decided not to. This is because that would produce just anecdotal evidence. And we're talking about medical tests here. There is no room for anecdotal evidence. Instead, I'll show you this. As per the manufacturer, these tests have more than 99% precision. Now, these strips have to be certified to be sold, so they have to prove what they say here. So, this is what really matters. These tests are the same doctors will do, alright? Now, a false positive may still be possible. This also happens when you do tests at a lab. So follow the instruction in the manual very carefully and, well, consult your doctor if the results are not what you were expecting. How to find these urinalysis strips? Now, as I was saying, I have two products. One is specific for kidney health and the other is made for testing UTIs. But it may still be very useful as we have seen. The one for UTIs should be really easy to find everywhere. Check the links I've put in description. But obviously, if you need to test for creatinine levels, you need the other one. I've included a link for that one too. So guys, I understand this is a complex matter, so feel free to ask any question in comment if you have any doubt. I really hope the information in today's video will be of help. As usual, keep taking good care of your kidneys and be good to yourself. This is all for today. Thank you for watching.